Oh, God. Hey everybody, this is Matt Rosoff, a loyal Angels fan. Welcome to the first video of an Angels fan reaction where we react to every Angels game in this COVID-shortened season. So, the Angels started off by opening up with a four-game series at the Oakland Coliseum in Oakland, California against the A's. So, I'm going to break down how that game went. Game one from last night, opening night, July 24th. So the game started off not really with much offense to go in the beginning. Angels had a chance with the bases loaded in the top of the first. Unfortunately, Albert Pujols struck out and no runs were scored, but that's okay. Still plenty of more baseball to play. So the next couple of innings, there's no scoring until we hit the top of the fourth inning and Brian Goodwin produces the first run of the Angels regular season with an RBI single. With Andrew Heaney on the mound to open the series against their starter for the Oakland A's, Frankie Montas, Heaney, gives up a solo home run to Ramon Laureano in the bottom of the fourth inning, and we are tied at one. The next couple of innings, there is no scoring right up until we hit the sixth, and two sacrifice flies, one from Brian Goodwin and then one from David Fletcher, to score another run, and the Angels now take a 2-1 lead. Yay! However, that lead would not last long, unfortunately, as we hit the bottom of the eighth inning. They have brought in Ty Buttrey, reliever for the Angels, and he unfortunately blows it by giving up an RBI single and then an RBI triple to Matt Chapman. Ugh, that's rough. But fortunately for the Angels, they tie it against the A's star closer, Liam Hendricks. If you watched him last year, you'll remember that he was an all-star. And boy, that was a breakout year for him. I think he was second in the AL, or the major leagues, to Kirby Yates of the Padres in terms of saves. Jason Castro ties the game off Hendricks in the top of the ninth inning. 3-3 is your score. 3-3. So Robles will come in for the bottom of the ninth, and then there was no score. No scoring for the A's in the bottom of the ninth inning, so we go to extras. So the new rule this year, for I'm sure some of you have heard it, maybe some of you haven't, we have now, for every half inning and extra innings, there will be a runner placed on second base. That runner is the runner who made the last out in the bottom of the ninth inning. So the Angels were the first to do this, so they made a little bit of history in this regard, with Shohei Ohtani starting on second base. Unfortunately though, Jared Walsh, one of our pinch hitters, hit a hard ground ball right to Matt Olson, and Shohei got himself in a rundown because he made a very critical mistake of running to third on hard contact. So that gave Olson the look to third to throw to Matt Chapman, who is another emerging star in this league, and he's a very good player. Shohei gets in a rundown. He unfortunately is gonna get tagged out, and Walsh didn't go to second, which he should have, but oh well. And then unfortunately, no one scores for us in the bottom or in the top of the 10th, so they go to the bottom of the 10th inning. Hansel Robles for the Angels is still in relief, and he unfortunately loads the bases after getting one out, so they go to Hobie Milner, and this happens.
Bruh.
Oh, God. Oh, well. Still got plenty of games left in the season. Fortunately, I predicted the Angels to have at least one win, so therefore, I still have 59 more chances to get it right. So let's see if they do better on Saturday against Sean Manaea, who will go up against our new acquisition in the offseason of Dylan Bundy. So guys, let me know what you think of this reaction video down in the comment section below. And that will wrap up Game 1's reaction. I will see you in the next one for Game 2. Go Angels!